First of all, you need to a program that turn your touchpad into a tablet. So how do you do that? First of all, go to your website and search for AbsoluteTouchEx here. Get the first link of Aspern. It will lead you to the GitHub page. You can take your time and read everything here before going to the main project. But I already read it, so I will quickly go to the release page here to download the file. Here, download the AbsoluteTouch.zip file here. I already downloaded it here for you guys. Now, you don't need to decompress it. Just click on it. And now, also it's actually a 32-bit program. It is not a 64-bit program, and if your window is running at 64-bit, like my window is 64-bit, but also still 32-bit, so you have to open the 86 here. You have to go to the 86, which means 32-bit. Okay, copy all these files. Okay, just copy all key files. Then go to your OSU main folder and paste it. Here you go. Now, you have to go to start and search for CMD. Oh, run an administrator. Yes, here. There's two things you need to note about this. First of all, if your OSU main folder is in the C drive, you don't have to do anything. Just skip this part. But if you have your OSU in another folder, like for me, like if you were having your file in the E drive, or the F drive, you have to check your directory. For me, I have the main folder in the C drive, so I don't have to do this part. But for if you have another part, do exactly what I do. First, CD, it means change directory, and slash D, it means drive path. Then your file folder is with me E right now. Then okay, then slash, and bam, it is the E drive now. Now CD again, copy your OSU file folder and paste it here. Well, I forgot that my file is C drive, not E drive. So I'm just gonna do this again. C drive. Now CD, your main folder. Okay. And it will lead to the OSU file. Like this. Okay, you see this AT loader file here? You have to type in atloader.exe. Then paste your directory again. Then slash osu-touch.exe. And bam. If you show this window, it means you have done it. Now it will boot up with OSU automatically. Yeah, just like that. Let me close that real quick. Okay, so you've done it. But one more thing you have to do that you need to have a precision touchpad, because it's only work with precision touchpad, like already said here. Window precision touchpad drivers. How do you do this? First of all, well, actually you could just search Google for this, because a lot of there's a lot of that. Just apps precision touchpad like that. It has a lot of like tutorial online like this. I will send the link to this file down description. But you have to check it first, this touchpad setting here. I didn't have the driver yet, so it didn't show here. I mean, this is a new computer. My old computer got broken from the last time. Yeah, just do whatever the tutorial said here, and you will have that precision touchpad. I'm using a That's it is. That pretty much is. So if you have any. If you have any question on like you can't do it, or you're missing something that you can boot up your game, just DM me on Discord. I'll put my Discord ID down in the description. My DM are open, so yeah, feel free to DM me and chat with me anytime, or joining EM community. Well, there's a lot of stuff to do there. Why not? So see you in the next video. See ya.
The Sona Pen stylus is cool and all, but it is around $50, and that's a bit expensive. And let's say you can't even afford the $2 stylus because you're like poor as hell. Don't worry, I got a solution for you too. Get a pair of scissors, get some rubber bands, and a bag of chips. Also a pen, because you need a pen. First you're gonna do is you're gonna cut open the bag of chips and literally eat everything inside. After which you're gonna cut up and wash the bag so that you're left with this sheet. Cut up the sheet so you're left with this tiny piece of foil. Now get the rubber bands and the pen from earlier and tie it together. Now the way this works is actually that static from your hand is traveled through the foil into the tip of the pen, and it kind of works like a press. And surprisingly, it does work really well as a stylus.